keep this zeal, keep this energy, keep this childlike innocence that we can make a difference and we are the difference and we will make the difference and really make it happen. Follow line, but I have a I'm not being cynical, but I think you guys have to be wrong. You guys have to make this happen, and not just the kids, I think all of us have to bring back that child in us and believe that we can make a difference and we will be the difference. And it will happen, and it's looking good.
Remember the power of one. If you can make the change, then the change happens. With that message, thanks a lot for singing for us. And this anthem is going to catch on very, very soon, very quickly on Republic TV. But I request you to take your seat. And to help our guests also get a very good idea of what we're really talking about today, about Better India, what is it all about, year one, year two, we have this special presentation for you. So I would request for the audiovisual presentation to come on now, please. Round of applause for our Year 2 Better India campaign ambassador, Pariniti Chopra. How are you?
Very good. It was a shock. I was not ready to enter the room. Ready, come. First, let's sit.
So we'll have a lot of pictures as we go along, and all right, I'll just give them 2 minutes to just, yes, settle down. All right, so Pariniti, thanks a lot for joining here us. I think you need one
this
mic
one?
As well.
Hello.
Yes. All right, my pleasure to introduce Pariniti Chopra as Year 2 Campaign Ambassador, Better India. You've had, interestingly, associations in the past as well, which have been about the environment, which have been about, you know, being motivated to be the change yourself. And is that what, you know, motivated you to come on board in this campaign as well?
I think for me, first of all, good morning, good afternoon to everyone. I think for me personally, the most important thing is I've come from a very, very balanced and healthy childhood. My parents gave me a lovely, lovely childhood. And even though we lived in Ambala, which was a very, very small town, somehow within my home, I never felt any kind of issues, you know. And so today when I'm in a position where I can connect with so many people worldwide, I feel I have to use it to my advantage. And I have to speak to people about things that genuinely matter to me. So things like cleanliness, environment, women empowerment, equality, education, everything that matters to me and was given to me so easily, I have to inculcate those thoughts and that ease in today's children's and hopefully adults if I can influence them.
We have a few children who've been participants and winner from year one of Better India.
Yes,
they're
hi.
Waiting to talk to you as well.
Yes,
and we'll
yes,
come
yes.
to them in just a bit. But before that, you have Suman Majumdar from DHFL Primerica also with you. He's someone who's curated this campaign from year one to year two. And this year, we're going to be looking forward to recycling a lot.
Yeah, year two is better because I'm here now, no?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Year one was not that good, no? You have to say it.
It was good, but it's going to become better now.
Yeah, it was, I feel okay. And then it's excellent now.
It will be excellent. Come on, guys, it'll be excellent, yeah.
Okay, it's fine, huh?
So tell us, I mean, do you focus on recycling in personal life? I mean, because, you know, today we've become so consumerist that we have so many things, we often don't notice how much we consume in terms of just things.
I very much do. And I'm not saying this because I'm here. I'll tell you another thing about myself. I never get associated with any campaign, brand, any initiative if I don't believe in it myself. Because I can't read from a list of answers. I can't learn answers. So whenever I'm on stage, I have to speak from personal experiences. And it has to be the truth. That's the way I function. So I actually do. I actually have 2 waste paper baskets at home. There is hardly any plastic in my house. I mean, even a straw is not kept in my house. Plastic bags are not kept in my house. Everything is recycled. if there's any kind of tin cans, anything that it's all sent. So I actually have a full-on system in my house.
Wow. So I hope the young kids are listening because the challenge for them is this year to recycle. Straws is a very good example, isn't it? We don't really need them. So I don't know why they're there. And they're actually very toxic for the environment. So one message that should go out is just to not use stuff, Suman, that is not required in life.
Yeah. It's absolutely like that. You will see there is an organic or recyclable alternative to everything. It can be right from a spoon, a glass, a straw, to the paper bag, the shopping that we do, the wrapping that we do. Everything can be paper. Everything can be natural. But we are just so used to the ease of plastic, etc., that we don't want to make an effort. We're like, it's fine. It's been going on for years. It'll go on in my lifetime.
Yeah.
You know, we'll deal with it later.
Or but my future generations will
deal with
it. Yeah,
my kids will do it. 30 years. Somebody else will do it. So it's always some other person. But you cannot wait for some other person. You have to do it because we are the persons living on this planet. So all of us have to make that change.
Suman, I'd like you to share your thoughts as well on having Pariniti on board.
Yeah, let's talk about that.
Okay, great guys. You know, so before I start my thoughts on having Pariniti on the show and the campaign, I need to give her a good piece of news, okay? So this year, we have recycling, right, as one of the tasks. And I'm happy to share with you that the first school which has started with recycling is Army Public School from Ambala.
What are you saying?
Yes, absolutely. And so we are launching it today. But as a trial, I mean, obviously, we reached out to a couple of schools, right? And as a soft launch, and we said, let's see in case the process works or not. So that was the first school which adopted this. And the moment you said Ambala, I thought, I mean, so you need to hear this.
Oh, wow. So Army Public School is the school that my brothers went to. There were only two good schools when I was growing up in Ambala. One was Convent of Jesus and Mary, where I'm from. And then the other good school was Army Public School. So I'm really happy. We should go to Ambala and do something.
And have her brothers there as well. And
But I'm really happy. But I mean, honestly, like, we're joking about it. But it's really, 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 really important. I'll give you another insight. I like to scuba dive a lot. So I scuba dive every 3 months. And I can't tell you the amount of, sorry for my language, shit that you see underwater. I mean, there are fish that are drowning. How can a fish drown, right? They are drowning because they're choking on plastic bags and things like straws. It's become so bad. And if the oceans become dirty, the earth will not survive. Yes. So it's really, really crucial that we make changes right now. It's very important.
Absolutely. Remember, 70% of Earth is the ocean. So if we don't keep them clean, that's a lot of Earth not clean. I would like, for Pariniti to kind of give a word of encouragement to some of our winners. We've got Trisha Komitla. She's the winner of the full campaign last year. Trisha, why don't you stand up? Don't be shy. So she's the one who won the entire thing last year. So big round of applause for her. And your word of encouragement for all our kids here as well. Yes, come.
I was just asking if I can go down and talk to them because I feel really rude.
I think they have some few questions for you as well. Why are you sad? Yeah, why don't we just have a seat here itself?
Sorry, guys. I hope you can still see. Yeah. And that's what I was saying when I started, that I also personally got involved in this campaign because I really think with even the basic amenities that my parents gave me, I did have a bathroom. I did have a clean bathroom. I had electricity. Most of India doesn't have that. And I can't imagine that. I can't imagine that, you know, there are people who are going through such basics not being given to them. So I'm so happy. I think nobody listens to adults anymore. People only listen to children because they make sense when they talk. I genuinely believe this. So I'm so glad and thank you. Really, thank you for that.
We have here, he was second placed, right? You have something to share about your experience as well?
I like this campaign a lot. And I've been doing social work before this campaign. And when I got to know about this campaign, I knew that this was the best medium we could get to spread awareness among the masses. So that's
how old are you?
15.
You're 15?
Yes, ma'am.
I was not this good when I was 15. Yeah. But amazing. Thank you. Thank you so much. Please, you also tell. She's the only one smiling. So tell us.
Our family always encouraged us to always help others and be humble, and that's why we always, during everyone's birthdays, we used to go to orphanages and then donate books, notebooks, then food, and they used to be really happy, and we used to spend days with them, and we used to understand them. And then afterwards, I thought it's only us as a family doing that, but how many other people are doing this? Then Better India was launched, and through our school we all worked together. We got a good team, and together we like worked for this campaign, and we thought that we should spread this towards everyone, and the three sectors, health, hygiene and vatavaran, those were like really good sectors, and we thought of something innovative, because now all these autistic people, they also have a right and they are equal in the society. So we started working with them, and we went to this organization called Bubbles Autism School, where we baked cakes together, and we tried collecting funds last year by baking cakes and selling them.
Wow. Can you believe that? That's amazing. Please give her a hand, guys.
This is the kind of small things that kids can do to come together.
I can't believe they're teenagers. That's what's shocking me, that teenagers are doing this. I'm so ashamed.
They are very much the driving force. I have Monica here as well. She was the coordinator from Wellham Boys. Unfortunately, the kids couldn't be here, but can you share your experience as well?
So, you know, the ranking apart, I feel the lessons drawn from the program need to become a part and parcel of all the students. That is very important, yes. Not just an outreach program. Yeah. So now that you are the ambassador for Better India, what's your message for the kids?
Tell them to get some.
I just want to say, you kids are much better off than even my generation is, and I'm not very much older. Let me confirm that to everyone, guys. I'm not very much older, but suddenly I'm feeling older today, you know. But I just want to say that you guys are literally rock stars as compared to us, because I think while we were growing up, the changes were still happening. It did not reach a dire situation like it is today. And I'm so sad that we've reached that state where everybody now has to actively live their lives and make changes to the planet. But I'm so proud of you. Please continue, is what I would say. And don't get complacent later, because it's very easy to start with a bang, with motivation, and then a year later you tend to get bored and you get distracted by other things. So please don't let that happen. We have to live on this planet for many, many years. So let's keep it clean and healthy, I think.
All right, with that message. All right. So Parinidhi, why don't we go back upstage?
Oh, okay.
We've got a few of our panelists who would like to interact with you as well. So we'll go back. We'll add a couple of chairs as well. Suman, why don't you come back with us as well?
Sure, please.
And I would like to call upon Meenakshi Batra. Meenakshi, ma'am, if you can come back on stage. If you want to do pictures, let's do it now.
Yeah?
Yeah, we'll do yours. Should we do one with the kids as well? We'll do it in a bit. Yeah. All right, so... Meenakshi is from Charities Aid Foundation. Sorry, ma'am, we couldn't get a word with you last time. And let me also call in Mr. Kaushik Chakrabarty from JLL. He, you know, JLL has been a partner with Better India in year one, and they're going to be partners going forward as well.
5 minutes.
We'll do one with the kids and everyone, with the logo and everything. Thanks a lot. And if I can have Ms. Namita Vikas back on the stage as well from Yes Foundation and Yes Bank. Please come, ma'am. Why don't you come here? No, you sit there. Ma'am, come.
Hi, ma'am. Hi.
Nice. Suman, why don't you come here? No, no, come here. In any case, we're going to do a quick round table. Yes, one sec. We'll just do it in 5 minutes, sir. Just give us 5 minutes. I just want Mr. Kaushik to very quickly share his experiences from last year, because Mr. Kaushik, you were part of the campaign last year. Just very quickly, give us a sense of what makes it so worthwhile for any corporate to come together on board.
We were talking about, it's a great opportunity for any corporate to really get into nation building, you know, in a way. The three pillars that we are talking of, Swachhata, Swastha, and, you know, Paryavaran, environment. You know, it's for the future of the country. And if you really see the whole campaign, you know, it's not really about corporate social responsibility. We are talking about a collaborative social responsibility. And we are touching the life of children through children.
Yes.
You know, so there is this whole network. You're actually contributing to the future of the country. And I don't think there has been any campaign, you know, which really connected so well the private enterprise with the government as well as with children.
Absolutely.
I mean, that's the beauty of this particular program.
You've really hit the nail on the head, because that is what makes this campaign truly unique and truly worthwhile. Because, and Meenakshi ma'am, you know, this brings about real change on the ground, because you're the one who's actually the interface between the kids who are collecting stuff or, you know, doing the donations to the kids who are actually getting it. So share your experiences with how, you know, kids' lives are being impacted actually on the ground.
So at Charities Aid Foundation, our sort of role was to bring this idea to action. So we, you know, worked quite closely with our partners, the NGO partners on the ground, who found these government schools and interacted with the kids and started sort of, you know, rolling out the whole program benefit to those kids. And with awareness raising that was done at the school level with the kids. So, you know, once someone becomes aware of the issues and how to sort of, you know, protect themselves, prevent the diseases. Mm. That also sort of enables ones to seek, you know, the benefits or the rights or, you know, the other support facilities. And also at the same time, I feel strongly that it also attracts. It's not just I'm seeking, but also then, you know, once I have a frame of mind and I start, in, you know, working in a certain manner, I also attract a lot of attention. And that is what actually happened on the ground. Once the awareness was raised with the kids, a lot of other partners joined on the ground. So it was not just a collaboration at the corporate level, at our level, but also on the ground there was a lot of collaboration that happened. The local leaders, the communities, the schools, the health authorities, they all sort of came together to make this program successful. And so there were lots of things that initiatives which were taken by authorities, which we probably hadn't really initially thought about. Mm-hmm. And so the fumigation was done, and then that followed through. It was not just that it was a one-off thing. It followed, it kept happening.
Continuously. Continued. So it is continuous change and
Absolutely.
Continuous preservation.
Absolutely.
Namita ma'am, if I can just quickly take your comments on how you think Better India can continue to be sustainable, and your message to the kids as well, because through Yes Foundation, you deal with change makers yourself.
Thanks. I think, you know, it's very important to focus on collaborations here. And we heard the other panelists mention about how relationships work. So government really provides a large scale. Civil society like CAF really brings in that ground level connect, because it all comes from the heart. And really the corporates bring the management skills to the table. So what DHFL is really doing, or what Yes Bank is doing, Yes Foundation is doing, is that last mile connect. And I think these kind of tripartite or collaborations would bring about the change that we are looking for. Mm. I think to the kids, it is very important. You are the change that you see yourself, you want yourself around. And we heard Pariniti also very nicely mention about how some influences have been been on your mind as a child which you want to take forward. I think this is a brilliant initiative. We would also like to come forward and collaborate. I think, Suman, it's a brilliant thing that you're doing, and congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you. We really look forward to everybody's appreciation and stepping forward to be part of this campaign. And Pariniti, you asked, right? I mean, so what is the difference I'm making? Guys, you know, when she walked in, obviously I didn't know her as a human being, right? I've seen her work professionally, so that she's great. So there was a beautiful face coming forward. But when she spoke, right, and the way she spoke, she didn't have to go down there, sit down there, but she did that, okay? And that was not part of some rehearsed script or something like that. She just did it on her own. So when you have a beautiful person, you know, a pretty person with a pretty mind, I think you become a beautiful person. Thank you so much for doing this. And
sweet, yeah. I'm feeling shy now. thank you.
Suman. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot for all of our panelists here. I would like to invite our winners from our year one to please come on stage for the picture with Pariniti. Yeah, we can have all the kids who are in the audience come up. Yeah.
Guys, all the kids who are sitting there, please, guys, can I request you to line up here, please?
Come. All the kids can please come up.
Everybody.
Yeah. No, all of you have to scream, okay? One.